Okay. Nothing major.
So fatigue is not an issue for you?
No, I don't think so. Okay. I also have an underactive thyroid, which I've had for 23 years.
A hypothyroidism. Yeah. So you're on treatment for that?
Yeah,
okay.
Weight gain.
Yeah.
A lot of women put weight gain down to menopause.
Mm.
For me, I just have to sort my life out to not put on weight.
Mm.
It's harder, it is now an issue. I have to exercise every day.
Mm.
And I have to watch what I eat.
Mm.
So I'm saying to women, you have to want to be slim more than...
Yeah, yeah.
Than just sitting back and letting it happen.
Yeah.
Is that wrong? Do you get to a point where you put on weight and you cannot do anything about it?
It's not wrong, it's true. You know, what happens in the menopause is that you have a different fat distribution than you had in the fertile years. So, and again, this is a hormonal issue. The fat will come and stay more in the belly, instead of the hips. In the menopause, you have generally less hormones. You have less estrogen, so the fat distribution is different, and you have also less testosterone and less androgens generally. That will lead to the fat on your belly. So you get more fat here, right, in this area. And this is again where the hormones can help. If you take the right amount of testosterone or another androgen, like for example the DHEA, that will help you a lot to stay lean, fit. By the way, that will increase also the sexual drive, testosterone,
or
the sexual drive.
DHEA.
Yeah. Exactly. DHEA.
And you can buy that over the counter, can't
exactly,
you?
Exactly, exactly, exactly. It's safe. DHEA is like the mother of the hormones, is the hormone from which also estrogen and testosterone will be produced. It's to get flat belly. And get better muscles in your abdomen, then testosterone is even more effective than the DHEA.
You're all listening to that.
Yeah.
Everybody wants a flat.
Yeah, exactly,
flat
exactly.
Even
yeah, even men. Men take testosterone in a bigger amount, mm-hmm. in a bigger doses. But yes, of course.
So if I took too much, would I get a moustache?
You will get, if you take too much, you will get hair in your face, you will get acne, your voice can get deeper. So, but of course you will not get that much that you will have, you will turn to...
Okay, so stick to what it says on the container.
Exactly, exactly.
So there is something that can be done about
weight gain
in menopause.
Exactly, about weight gain and about better fat tissue distribution. The metabolism, of course the diet as well, for that it's good to talk with a nutritionist. Sometimes we think that we do the right things. For example, we go swimming, right? And we think that's the best exercise for staying fit. And it's a very good exercise, for example, for the heart. But it's not a good exercise to prevent osteoporosis, for example.
No, it's not weight back.
Exactly. You need weight. You need resistance. The same when you do exercise with resistance or endurance, you increase the testosterone levels in your life.
But running is not enough.
No, running is not enough. Running is very good for the cardiovascular system, but
I'm only a runner.
Yeah. You should start, having some resistance, whatever you like,
I know I have to do it, I know.
But
it's just a question of, my routine is just go for a run and that's it.
I know.
Get on with the rest of my day.
But see, sometimes we have to change our routine, otherwise. I really do. Yeah.
Practice what I preach.
Yeah. So that's why we think we do the right thing, or we eat. We say we eat salads, we eat, but the combination is very, very important. Because sometimes you might eat too many fibers. So if you take too many fibers, you cannot absorb, for example, calcium. So, and you will have a calcium deficit.
Well, should you get that checked?
You get that, not everything, but some main things, your calcium level, maybe your magnesium level, or if they do, the nutritionist will check for something more sophisticated according to your needs. I can give you some tips, for example, what is good for calcium, what is good, what you should do for osteoporosis in terms of diet.
Google that.
Yes, of course, we can Google everything.
Yeah, but not necessarily the right answers, like the itchy shoulders.
It's better to talk always with someone who, you know, deals with that every day. Because it's a combination of things. It's important to have a holistic kind of approach.
What about not seeing a doctor? Because up to now, I've been thinking, you know, I've got hot sweats, got the sweaty thing going on. I can manage my life. Mm. I can stay slim through my exercise, etc. I know I should be doing weight-bearing exercise. When I went to see Dr. Natalia, mm-hmm. I didn't think I needed to see a dermatologist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But since I've seen her, my life has changed.
Yes, yes.
So going to see somebody, even though you don't really think you need to, may just make life
exactly.
Easier.
There are two approaches. The one is to go and treat whatever problem you have, okay? And the other is to go and see a doctor because you want to do something for the quality of your life.
Proactive.
This is where the anti-aging, or I like to say well-aging, you could have started with HRT, for example, with hormonal therapy. Way before that, our hormones generally starting to decline since we are in the late 20s. Actually, if you want to stay young or stay healthy, it's not a bad idea to start taking as supplements. You optimize your hormones. And it's not only the estrogen, there are many other hormones.
Interesting. I've never thought of that. So really, I should be getting my daughter in here to talk to you.
Yeah, how old is your daughter?
Well, she's only 23, but...
Okay, 23, yes. Mm. So that she's aware, you know, and maybe after some years, she starts doing things. Yeah.